Hey everyone, Swampfox here, and we're going to move on to the next area of Talador. You need to be at least level 94, I'd like to reiterate that. Once you hit level 94, there'll be a couple quests in your garrison. Bounty, Twisted Ancient, collect the... It's pretty much just to get garrison resources, go kill someone. And this one is to just take you to Talador. Not to mention that this is also in Talador, which also takes you to Talador. But, if you're still at High Pass, which is where we're into currently, you obviously want to grab these quests at the garrison just because you need that little extra XP. Vindicator here is going to have another quest for you, too, to head to Talador.
What news from the front?
Broadwick Gray sent word from your garrison that they have spotted a fleet from the fleet of Iron Horde at the shores of Talador. We must not allow them to destroy Shadra.
We must not fail.
We must not. Aw, okay, never mind. Grab that quest first, and don't do what I just did. Grab that quest first, and then fly to your garrison and grab those other three quests. Now you guys gotta...
Have you any news?
You guys gotta watch me fly all the way back to my freaking garrison. Well, while we're waiting, do a couple things. Throw it up on the big board. I'll do all the bonus objective videos later. Don't let the Talador hit you on the way out. Establish an outpost. The outposts in each area are kind of neat. You can't change the decision, though, after the fact. That is worth noting. So, whatever you choose, that's what you get. Also... the quests in the area are specific to what outpost you choose. So, in the last area, Gorgrond, there's two things you could choose, Lumber Mill and the Arena. The Arena had you doing quests in the north, and the Lumber Mill had you doing quests in the south. So if you want a different gameplay experience, choose a different outpost. The passive buffs that they give are very... They're not really important. It's just a matter of preference, I guess, for the first time you go through. Corrupted lumber. Oh, he's right outside. Oh, then we'll grab that right now. It'll only take a minute. You guys have already waited long enough. Waited a little bit. You can wait a little longer, right? This is gonna take 3 to kill him. We'll see about that. See where this big fella is. Corrupted by fell energies. Oh, there's already someone else attacking him. Bring it on! Immune. to him yet. Where the hell's my garrison? Okay, good.
Orders, Commander. I'll call in a few favors for the Alliance. My men are standing ready.
Nope, not doing that yet. Man, it's hard doing guides for you guys. I can't do a lot of stuff. Let's go check out Kadar back at that outpost. Before he, I have the flight master there, flies to Talador. See what Kadar has to say. Hello, Moonbark Agent. I'm just gonna keep walking by you. You don't worry about me.
Together, we will defeat the Shadow Council.
Hello again, Helmshammer. You're just in time. We've tracked the Shadow Council to a nearby village. I suspect that Gul'dan is with them.
Be vigilant, friend.
Catching his eye.
Keep your guard up.
It's better there take me to Talador.
We can learn here.
Need someone I can trust. You're the only one in few. The woods and the orc Gulvar are protected from my scrying magic. We need to pierce that veil. I think I know a way. There's a fell presence within the woods. A demonic watcher is there, hidden in the cave from which it casts its all-seeing gaze. I would like you and the warden to capture it.
Come back in one
I'm going
piece.
Ahead to the demon's lair. We'll capture it together.
The priestess of the moon also has something to ask of you.
The loom be with you.
The shadow moonwell. The archmage has asked me to prepare this moonwell. Once it is completed, I'll be able to sanctify its waters for use against the demon. Only one thing remains. A piece of one of the Draenor's moons has fallen into a nearby pool on the far side of the woods. Such a thing is perfect for use in the dedication of the moonwell to a loon. Collect a chunk of moon rock. I feel like this isn't technically Talador stuff, but it did unlock for me, and it is going to take me to Talador, so... Yeah, it's a pretty big moon rock. Whoop. Something about a cave, too. That looks ominous. Excuse me, Mr. Grunt. Get over there. Velos. Time to die, Velos. Damn, I'm not buffed or nothing.
Take it back to the outpost and see that it's some foul creature.
Nothing in here. Ooh, hey, ore. Pointed out to a lot of my friends and such, but as you can see, apparently my helmet cannot contain
if you stay out of sight, Khadgar.
I am not a child to cower beneath your cape, Cordana.
As soon as we have enough blessed water from the priestess's moon well, we'll break the demon's will and use it as a proxy to see into Govar. That way they won't use the scrying upon us. First, we need to weaken their shrouding magic. Long ago, the shaman of the Shadow Moon clan erected three stones in the woods. There, they performed their sacred rituals, blessing the beasts and the trees. Now someone has placed a fell magic upon the stones. The corruption is what shrouds the village of Gulvar. Before we can use the captured demon to safely peer into the Shadow Council's village, we must bring down those stones.
For Azeroth. Be wary. I suspect the stones will be heavily guarded.
The White Lady will be pleased. Now I shall go about the business of preparing the Moonwell water for use in the Archmage's plan. But first, I wonder if you'd be willing to help me again. The Warden brought back very disturbing stories about the creatures in the woods. Cordana tells me that the creatures of the woods are cursed by the same villain as she's keeping Kadar from scrying into the Orc village. This will not do. If we were on Azeroth, I could find a cure in a reasonable time frame. However, we are not, nor do we have the luxury of time. Better to put a swift end to their suffering rather than allow these poor creatures to linger with demonic energy.
Go in peace.
I don't want to kill that guy. I already killed him once.
Oh.
That cursed wolf? Oh my god, that's pretty sick. Do the toads count? Oh, they totally do.
I can't start yet. I can't attack.
I'm just gonna murder all the toads.
I need a target. Heck is that? Vicious throw. Ow. This place looks ominous. Yeah, right. No prisoners. Starfall Outpost. Those cursed wolf skins. Those are pretty cool. If I was a hunter, I'd totally tame one of those things. Now that the veil has been lifted from the woods, we can make use of the demon. We will convince it to turn its eye upon Gulvar and show us what the Shadow Council is planning. Now that the priestess Moonfang has created the blessed water, it is time to deal with the demon. Take the water and the scripture of Alun. Through the power of each, you will compel the demon to show us what the orcs are up to at Gulvar.
Keep your guard. Be careful. The demon will try to trick you.
I am honored.
Grim business. I wish that I could have gone differently. Thank you for your dedication, Helmshammer. Be comforted in the fact that Alun understands. Stay away from me with those things. I can see the emptiness in your soul, Helmshammer. In the end, it will be I who compels you. Lovely day for a compulsion. Do I just keep using it? Your ancestors will languish.
Oh.
By the the power of Jesus be compelled.
Tomorrow.
Never thought I'd have to perform an exorcist before.
Is power. Together we will defeat the Shadow Council.
Soul Shards of Summoning. It's good to know what Taran Gore and Cho'Gall are up to. It's more important that we stop Gul'dan. Some of his disciples can summon minor demons. To do this, the lesser warlocks must use Soul Shard. The foul crystal creates a connection to the Twisting Nether, pulling a demon through against its will. Gul'dan's as much a demon as he is orc. If we can gather some more potent shards, we can combine them into something that might just capture him.
Come back in one piece.
I don't trust this
place. He doesn't want me going with you, but I can help by magically projecting myself.
You're right, you're not going out there.
Katara wants you to concentrate on Gul'dan, but that doesn't mean we're not going to take down the Shadow Council in the process. Gul'var's filthy with Shadow Council villains. Let's do something about them.
Don't let down your guard.
Uh, That's one shard. Is there another one over here? Nope, it's just a true iron deposit. Well, I guess I'll just complete some quest over here. Where are you, beautiful? There you are. Guessing way down here. And I would be correct. Is that thing? Four more. Practically done. Die,
I can't attack that target.
Why would you? That PN's like, hey, look, invaders, instead of, you know, being thankful that I'm saving him. Thank you.
the shards, Helmshammer. Now all that's left to do is to fashion them together into something strong enough to snare cool down. Luckily, we can do that right here. Heart on fire. We have the shards, but now they must be combined. There's a forge here, but even these fires aren't hot enough for our purposes. However, there's a demon nearby that burns hot as the sun. Gul'dan, or perhaps Razun, has managed to summon an infernal. The thing calls itself Crossness, which means furnace. The demon's heart burns hotly enough, all you need to do is collect it. Aw, someone got here before me. Person that was
too far away.
Stuff on me. Combined might of the shards, we should be able to trap Gul'dan. Quickly, place the heart in the forge. We'll use its infernal heat to forge the trap. The fiery heart of Crossness is in the forge. We have the soul shards. Now all that's left to do is stoke the fires and combine all these foul components into a trap for Gul'dan.
Quickly, combine the shards to forge a soul trap for Gul'dan.
Forge the soul trap. There's no time to waste, Helmshammer. We must capture Gul'dan. I think it'll take my time, actually. To catch Shadow, Gul'dan is on the Shadow's Rise, just up there in the hill to the west. But you must hurry, Helmshammer. We know that he's about to leave for Talador and Frostridge. The use of my soul trap is straightforward. Simply point and shoot the incinerate Gul'dan. The crystal will take care of the rest. I'll see you back at Starfall Outpost when you have him. Assuming all things
go well. Be careful, my friend. Gul'dan is not to be underestimated, no matter how prepared you might be.
Okay, there we go.
I remember you. I am not that easy. Razun, your time has come. Have fun dealing with this.
Well, that's not good. Presents are never good when they come from cooldown. Ooh, that tickled.
What news?
Every world is better off without those demons.
Don't let the Archmage down.
We will find a way through this.
Together, we compelled all seeing eyes by the Shadow Council.
Observe and reflect.
Unfortunate, but not surprising. At least we were able to defeat one of the inner council members. All is not lost. Helmshammer, we know what this Shadow Council is up to and where they're headed. But we group in Talador. Together, we'll put an end to Taran Gore and his plans for Arcadoon.
For Azeroth. Commander, what's wrong?
Uh-oh.
Khadgar, someone's here.
Sorceress, assassin! Coward!
Gul'dan sends his best.
I knew it. You should have stayed back at the garrison, Archmage.
Nonsense. I had that handled. Cool as a cucumber.
Ice block for the win.